The following production is part of the Play Some Video Games Podcast Network.
I say it's time we focus on what really matters. The games.
Hello and welcome to this special sideshow edition of the PlayStation Experience podcast. This is an off week for us, not a regular episode, but we still did want to check in and kind of go over the news of the last week or so, things that people are talking about in the world of PlayStation. And actually, over the last week, there have been a lot of news items. But before I get into those, I want to introduce myself. I am the host of the PSXP podcast, Seth Roy, and this is the PlayStation arm of Play Some Video Games at psvg.blog and part of the Make Us Better podcast network. Please visit patreon.com/makeusbetter to learn more about our entire network of podcasts. So I wanted to start this week with the drop, with the games that are released. This is, of course, today as this releases, it is Wednesday, October 17th. The big games coming out this week on the PlayStation 4. We have For Honor, the Marching Fire Edition, which is sort of an updated version of the For Honor Knight Samurai battling game that released last year. Also, I guess they have Vikings and Wulin Warriors. Kind of looking down through, there's also Jackbox Party Pack 5 out this week, Lego DC Super Villains, NBA 2K Playgrounds 2. As I roll through the drop here, it is Palm Reading Premium. You can learn how to be a palm reader, apparently. And finally, Soul Calibur 6 and Starlink Battle for Atlas are kind of the those are probably the two big releases this week. Starlink Battle for Atlas being the kind of space shooter with the Toys to Life stuff that you attach to your controllers. And Soul Calibur 6, the fighting game in the classic series. This one includes Geralt from The Witcher. So it feels like a quieter week game release wise. In between, this month has had Assassin's Creed Odyssey, Call of Duty. We've got Red Dead Redemption next week. But there are still some pretty big hitters out this week. And moving on from there, did want to take a check. I'm recording this after the store has updated. So the sales this week, there's a big Fallout sale. They're calling it the Bombs Drop Sale. You can pick up Fallout 4 for $14.99, 50% off the normal price. And all of its various DLCs are also discounted. The Fallout 4 Game of the Year edition is $29.99. That includes every piece of DLC in Fallout 4. Also, Destiny 2 Forsaken is on sale at 35% off for the Forsaken Legendary Collection, which includes the core Destiny 2 game and all of the DLC released thus far. And those are really the two big sales out this week. Also, NBA 2K19 is on sale for $40, normally $60. So that is that. Looking at the PSN, the PlayStation Store's September top downloads, no surprise here, the top downloaded game on PS4 in September was Marvel's Spider-Man, followed up by NBA 2K19, FIFA 19, Battlefield 1, and Destiny 2 Forsaken. Rounds out the top five. Also, Grand Theft Auto 5 is number 8 on the list. five years after it was released. Top PSVR game released in September was Firewall Zero Hour, followed by Superhot VR and Creed Rise to Glory. On the Vita, we've got Hyperdimension Neptunia Rebirth 3 V Generation. Actually, the first three games on the Vita list are all Hyperdimension Neptunia Rebirth games. So that is it for the PlayStation Store downloads of the week. And now we'll head on into some news. Probably the biggest PlayStation-centric news that has come out since we last recorded is the PSN Online ID change feature is officially coming. You can now change your PlayStation names, or it's on its way, I should say. There will be some select users that have been past PS4 system software beta users who will be selected for the program and will be able to change their IDs. The first ID change will be free, and after that, it costs $10 to change your ID or $5 if you are a PlayStation Plus member. When you change your online ID, you'll have the option to display your previous ID with your new ID so your friends can recognize you. Once you make that decision, you'll either be displaying your old ID forever or you won't be. So, again, if you want to change your ID because you have an embarrassing one, you probably don't want that displayed at all. This feature will work with every PS4 game published after April 1st of this year and with select games published prior to April 1st. More information, of course, is on the PlayStation blog. At PSXP Podcast on Twitter, I ran a quick poll. Our highly scientific poll of 15 votes showed that 40% said yes, they are you are looking to change your PSN name, and 60% no. Which I don't know if I expected that to be higher. Obviously, it's a low vote total. But still, if that projects at all onto the wider PS4 audience, 40% of your audience wanting to change your name is quite a big audience. Another story that kind of broke over the last week: Sony confirms that it's working on the next PlayStation console. This is on Polygon, which is actually referencing a story with Financial Times that Kenichiro Yoshida, Sony's president and CEO, said, at this point, what I can say is it's necessary to have next generation hardware. They aren't saying, they don't know what it'll be called yet, whether it'll be the PlayStation 5 or something else. There's no word on a release window. But in May, John Cadera, CEO of Sony Interactive Entertainment, said that the next PlayStation is at least 3 years away. So I'm not at all. Nobody is surprised that they're looking at PS5 in terms of what the next generation will be. The PlayStation 4 at this time has sold 81.2 million units, which is more than the total lifetime sales of the PlayStation 3, but still is quite a bit short of the heights of the PlayStation 2 at 155 million. So that was a interesting thing. And then over the weekend, some places started reporting that this is from Kotaku, and it was on the PS4 Reddit board, that PlayStation 4 users are claiming that they're receiving messages that are preventing them from using their consoles. In several threads on the PS4 Reddit board, users are reporting they're receiving messages through the console's messaging application that are hard-locking their consoles. The stories all follow a similar pattern. Users receive a message, their controllers and sound outputs fail, and resetting the console results in continual error loops. It is apparently a string of characters that are sent in a certain order that kind of bricks your console. The way to prevent this is to set your message settings to friends only or no one, meaning that only your current friends or no one at all can contact you through through that system. Some users have claimed that doing a factory reset will delete the message and fix the problem, while others have claimed that the only way to fix the error is to delete the message while using the PlayStation Mobile app or by logging onto the account from a browser and deleting the message that way. PlayStation UK support has acknowledged the problem is a crash loop that can be fixed if users delete the message on the PlayStation Mobile app, go into safe mode, and use option 5 to get their console back to normal. So hopefully that is not impacting any of you. I have not seen it yet, and I am setting my console settings to only accept messages from people I know. And finally, the last news item I want to hit on, on the PlayStation blog, they revealed some of what the Spider-Man DLC is going to feature. Marvel's Spider-Man The Heist, out next Tuesday, October 23rd, adds 3 new suits. As you play Marvel Spider-Man The Heist, you'll encounter the beginning of a new interconnected story taking place over the 3 chapters of Marvel's Spider-Man The City Never Sleeps. That never sleeps. A robbery at an art museum entangles Spider-Man and MJ with an old flame from Peter Parker's past, Felicia Hardy, aka Black Cat. Beyond new story missions, there's a whole new faction of enemies, new crimes, new challenges, new trophies, and of course, 3 brand new suits. Here's a first look at the 3 new suits, and they show the pictures on here. They talk about the Resilient suit by famed Marvel illustrator Gabriel Del Otto. And then there's the Advanced suit, and continuing with a Velocity suit. Additionally, we have 2 more suits that fans of the comics will recognize, Spider-Man suit from Scarlet Spider 2 and the Spider UK suit from the Spider-Verse. And then there's pictures on that blog post. You can order the heist separately for $9.99, or you can order all 3 DLC story updates for $24.99 total to get you everything. And with that, that is the kind of the news of the week. This past week was pretty packed. You can join Justin and myself next week as we talk about what we've been playing and preview a bit of Red Dead Redemption 2 as it will come out at the end of next week. And if you have any questions or comments, please contact us on Twitter at PSXPPodcast, or you can also email PSXPPodcast@gmail.com, though honestly, Twitter is the best way to reach us. Thanks for listening.